Welcome to Raleigh, North Carolina, and the Wolfpack is gathering and starting to howl in Carter Finley Stadium as they are ready to see NC State go to work. Today, a ranked versus ranked matchup as a couple of top 25 teams get set to go jaw-to-jaw. As we'll see, the number 12 team in the country, the Utah Utes, taking on the 22nd ranked team in the land, the NC State Wolfpack. For EA Sports College Football, Reese Davis with you alongside David Pollack and Jesse Palmer. And guys, can't wait to get this one started. And no chance at a return here. They'll start this drive at their own 25. Apparently some confusion as the offense calls the timeout. It's their first of the half. Line gets set, first down. He's gonna pass. And the pressure gets there. And down he goes at the 18.
And I think this offense was looking for a reason to ignite the home crowd, coming out on first down, throwing the football, but the defense was ready. Nice job getting to the quarterback, making a big sack on the first play of the game.
Looking to throw, it's McCall. Throws to the tight end. Got a man in the middle. Can anyone catch him? And he's brought down after a huge completion.
I know it's early in the game, but defensively after that play, you know you have to tackle the catch. When this guy gets the ball in his hands, he is so dangerous after the fact. So it's okay for him to make catches. You just got to get him to the ground quickly.
That last play changed everything on this possession. They've got it first and 10 inside the 30. Looking to move it through the air. Grabbed behind the line. It's Collins. They make the stop, but the sweet pulling catch is plenty to give them a first down.
You can work your way down the field with these wide receiver screens, but also look for the opportunity to turn them into chunk plays later.
No doubt. You throw it quickly. You get it to him now. DB comes up, has to make a tackle. Now you fake it maybe a little bit later on. So these plays, they're not huge plays all the time, but they can set up big plays down the road for your offense.
Nice defensive play to get a hand in there and knock it away.
Defense, we're always trying to get some tips. You know, break on the football, get a tip, get it up in the air. Nice job by the player breaking on the football and forcing the completion.
Operating in the red zone here on second down. From the gun, the ground game. A solid pickup there before the defense is able to make the stop. Tight quarters deep in the red zone, but they can't pick up a first down without scoring. Third down. Snap it to the back. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one. Well, they call that an ISO play, and it was isolated for a loss.
And they try to isolate a linebacker inside and really run the football right at you, right down the middle. But you better move those big defensive linemen out of the way and create some space. They didn't do it, and you could tell that's why the ball went nowhere.
And this one splits the uprights. And that'll put the first points of the game on the board. It's 3-0.
This is a team that really prides themselves on starting fast. We've seen that before. And here they are playing at home today. Nice job on the opening drive. Lots of poise, good emotion. They don't get the touchdown they would have liked, but they kick a nice field goal. They've got the lead. The coach has to be happy with that.
The offense set for a first down play. He's looking to throw it. Catch in the middle, it's Parks. They make the stop after the catch and still some work to do to pick up that first down.
Well, this offense knew coming into this game they wanted to try to attack the middle of the field in the passing game, and they're able to execute the in route there.
Got some of the work done on first. Now let's see what they have on second down. From the gun to give, looking for room. And he's got enough for the first down. It'll be at the 35.
Well, I know this is an offensive line that has a ton of pride. They want to come out each and every game and really impose their will on the D-line. They got just enough push there on that run play to pick up the first.
Ball is at the 35. It's first and 10. He wants to throw. He looks that one in nicely. And he'll be tackled, but there is a flag on the field. Some hand fighting at the point of the catch will draw the penalty, but this one is going to go against the offense. Time winding down in the quarter as they come to the line. Looking downfield, it's Rising. Gonna let it fly. And that falls incomplete as they tried to wrap up the first quarter with a bang, but the incomplete pass takes us to the second quarter.
NC State 3, Utah 0. 0.
We'll get this quarter going with a second down play. Dialing up a second down pass play. He'll pull it down and run. At the 40, there he goes. He will step out of bounds, but not before the big pickup and a first down for this offense.
This guy just gives you nightmares. I mean, he's just got so much electricity. He just pulls it down and chews up yards like it's nothing. That's a quarterback. A quarterback doing that to your defense.
The Utes are on the move. Receivers telling the quarterback what they see. Comes out throwing on first down. Fires to the right. And the ball is intercepted. And he's wrapped up after a solid return on the pick.
What a big game-changing play. I love when you see defensive players, they jump on the ball like they were the offensive guy. So aggressive, going and getting that pick, creating some big mojo for your team.
Looking for space, it's Water. And he's able to shed one tackle, but still, just a very short gain.
Nice run there on first down. You know, this is a running back that gets better as the game goes on. So they're going to want to make sure they keep feeding him the football, let him get lathered up.
Solid pickup of 4 on first down at 2nd and 6. Leaves it with the back. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one. It's the 2-minute warning, and we'll see if the offense can tack a little something extra on their lead before the break. They'll try to move the chains on this 3rd and long from the 50. To the air, it's McCall. All kinds of room to throw that one in there.
And listen, the defense knew coming into this one, they were going to target him early and often. He is a weapon, and there's no mystery where the quarterback's going to be looking on critical down and distances. Let's see how they're able to cover him throughout the rest of this game.
Trying to find his man on first down. And it's incomplete. If you're going to take a hit like that, you might as well hang on to the ball. After misfiring, it's 2nd down. Out of the gun, the running back has it. And he'll step out of bounds after a very productive play.
Listen, you got to be able to know what play to call and what hole to go through. Like, the line blocks for a certain hole. Good job getting through the hole, getting what was blocked, getting a nice positive gain, making your situation really good on the next down.
Okay, right. Already in chip shot field goal range at the 21, but this 3rd and short, they're still thinking touchdown. From the gun, wants to pass. He took a hit as he threw it and couldn't deliver the football. It's incomplete, and 4th down's coming.
Well, on 3rd and short in field goal range, they dial up the pass play. Quarterback was trying to get through his progressions. There was just simply nobody open. Couldn't make an accurate enough throw. Ball falls incomplete. Now setting up a big decision here on 4th down.
And it's no good. It's still a 3-point game after the miss.
NC State 3, Utah 0.
On
The Utah offense returns ready to go back on the attack. That last drive was promising for a while, but you just can't mess it up at the end with the... It's a fumble on the play. Defense just cradling that fumble and securing it. And he's brought down in this defense. Ball back for its own.
I'll tell you what, that one stings a little bit. You're trying to get a drive together, trying to get some points to dig out of your hole. Now you turn it over right before the half. All the momentum shifts straight to the other side.
He spun that wheel of fortune by challenging the call, and it does not go his way, and he loses the timeout. Ready, here comes the offense onto the field again. Set, they'll move the running back to try to force the defense to adjust. Going to try to pop one on the screen. He was working his way toward that goal line. They'll stop him at the two after the big play up top.
And they executed that running back screen to perfection. Quarterback held onto it. He let the rush get to him. Offensive lineman got out in position, and the running back sold it too. Once he had the ball in his hands, he just had blockers and green field out in front of him. They pick up an explosive play on a running back screen.
Yeah, what a great job by the defense. You got to understand, it's physical time, right? They want to run the football when they start getting inside the five. Nice job getting penetration, getting the tackle for the loss.
On the option. He can't corral the pitch. The ball's on the ground. They recover their own fumble. Somehow, who knows how they got that thing back.
And as a defense, you just want to steal some possessions, create some turnovers. You force the fumble. But, man, what a break for the offense to fall back on it. Those are moments that you just get a little bit frustrated because it's the luck of a bounce.
It's still third and goal. The play action fake. Looking for the score. He's got it in the end zone. Touchdown Wolfpack. What a grab and what a quick strike that offense.
And when I'm an offensive coordinator and I see a short field, I'm thinking attack, attack, attack. Go get that touchdown. Take advantage of what the defense gave you. Great job by the offensive coordinator.
They'll try to add another to their lead. Oh, and he hit it off the left upright. No good. Quick work on that scoring drive, just four plays. And the score comes on a 12-yard touchdown pass. The ball bounces through the end zone, and it will be a touchback. Dwindling away as they try to put points on the board right before the half. Trying to start the drive with a pass. He slings it deep to the left. The pass falls incomplete, and there are 8 seconds left.
DB does an outstanding job here on the deep pass, locating the football, no PI, able to swat it away, passing it.
They'll spread the defense out, going five wide on second and 10. To the air. It's rising. He's not afraid to go deep. What a snag by the defense. Bringing it back. He's at the 30. And he gets the interception and finally run out of bounds. And that's how we'll wrap up the first half. NC State will kick off to start things here in the second half. On the run from inside his own five. Nice job executing all of the assignments as they put a stop to that return at the 22. Utah has it back and the offense coming onto the field. Not hard to figure out why they trail to start this third quarter. Three first-half turnovers.
So if you're on offense, let's just stay out.
And it's picked off for the third time today. And they'll close in on him after a good return on the interception. And the offense came out aggressively here in the second half, but they can't put the drive together and spin it up on the turnover.
I'll tell you, this defense has a lot of athletes. They've got a lot of guys with ball skills. If you put the football anywhere around them in their vicinity and their ability to catch the football, they'll come down with it. This quarterback has got to be way more careful here in the second half.
This guy can throw it. This offense has a second down play. A little pre-snap eye candy for the defense. Little touch pass to the receiver. They bring him down, but a solid pickup to put them in position to pick up a first down. Third down conversions are a huge stat, and this one would be a doozy if they can pull it off.
42 Spider.
To throw, it's McCall coming after him. And the double coverage, and they made him pay. It's intercepted. Going the other way, and he's got room. Running inside the 20. And with the interception, he'll take it all the way back. Touchdown, Utes. It is one thing to come up with the interception. No, 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 don't stop there. Turn it into a score.
Make a big play and don't be content. That's right, go out and make an even bigger play, and he does it. He makes the pick and then takes it all the way back to the house. Looked like a wide receiver, for goodness sakes. Turned on the Jets, making the big play.
And the PAT will draw them 1 point closer. They'll kick it off and send that defense right back out there to try to score again after the pick six. And it'll be a touchback. The ball will come out to the 25-yard line. Sending the offense back onto the field. And in a low-scoring game like this one, David, every possession is magnified.
And I think more than anything, it just gets frustrating. And you got to put that behind you. You got to see what this defense has been doing to be so successful. Palmer, now use it against them.
Yeah, David, I think for a play caller, this is tough, right? It's like you have to have the perfect play on just to get a first down. In these types of games, I think you're just trying to get guys out in space, see if a dude can break a tackle. Maybe that generates an explosive play, and it breaks this trend.
Fires to the wideout. Holds it in. He's run out of bounds, but not before. Turning in a big pickup and moving the sticks for a first down. A new set of downs after the completion. Caught behind the line. It's Concepcion.
I like the decision by the quarterback here. Just get the ball out of your hands. Get it to your playmaker. A lot of times he'll dance and make even bigger plays than he did here, but it's still a positive game.
Got it.
Picked up some yardage on the ground. Now here comes second down. From the gun, they'll try to impose their will. And stampeding through the defense. They'll finally drag him down, but not before he gets it to the 40, and it's a first down.
Man, who says you can't run up the middle anymore, right? Everybody thinks, I got to make big plays. I got to go way out to the left, way out to the right, way out in space. Nope, right down the middle. Nice blocking. How about the running back? You could tell the speed, the wheels, does a great job getting down the field, making a huge rushing play.
And they get him on the ground, and that'll probably do it for the third quarter.
How about the job by this defense today? They knew what they were getting into. A really good running back. We talked to him this week. It was the main focus point of this offense, stopping the run game, stopping the run game. Boy, have they showed up and showed out and answered that challenge.
We'll start the quarter offense about to snap it on second down.
29 Philly. 2-9 Philly.
The handoff, keep working on that clock. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
You got to give this defense credit because they have bottled this guy up all game long. He's one of the best running backs in all of college football. Everybody was expecting him to have a big one today. Don't tell that to this defense, though. They've played with great effort. They've gotten hats to the football, and they have been able to shut him down.
Throws to the wideout, and the third down pass is incomplete.
Nice job by the defense. They're mixing up their look there. Third and long in field goal range, they go zone coverage. So everybody on the back end has the eye on the quarterback, and they're able to break on the ball, force the incompletion.
Now this is rolling the dice, or perhaps they've gone outside their head. They're already up. Boy, this could really backfire if they don't convert on fourth down. Going over the top. He makes a grab. And they finally get him to the ground. An easy conversion for this offense. Defense, not exactly the perfect fourth down call there. And this defense has to step forward. Not only do they have to get a stop, they've got to do it quickly to keep that time from running down. And they get nothing. The ball remains at the 2-yard line.
And this is where the offense just breathes. Just take your time, huddle up. I'm in absolutely no hurry. I got the lead. I want to continue to run that clock. No false starts, no penalties. Let that clock tick down and then punch it in the end zone to add to this lead.
Second down here, and maybe they've got time to get one more snap off before the two-minute warning. Tries again to get it in. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple. Timeout called there by the defense, desperate to get the ball back and save as much time as possible. It's third down now, and they ought to be able to get off one more play before the two-minute warning. Back to throw. It's McCall. Fires into the end zone. And he reels it in for a touchdown, and that just might seal it. Now for the extra point try late in the game. And the extra point is good, and the lead is 9 here in the fourth. They put together a 74-yard touchdown drive, and they cap the drive with a 4-yard touchdown pass. Kickoff team is on the field. They'll try to drive this one deep. He'll bring it back from inside his 5. Able to find enough room to get it out across the 25. He's brought down at the 26. Utah offense returns, ready to go back on the attack. Let's see if this drive goes better than the last one. They were in and out quickly after the quick pick, David.
Yeah, first play, big mistake, man. Now, let's get this offense in a little bit of a rhythm. Maybe before you open it up again, Palmer, or do you trust him right away?
He seems to me like the guy maybe that just needs to kind of get into the flow of the game. So maybe you get the running game going here and just give him some easy looks to let him get by.
They'll spread the defense out, going five wide on second and 10. He's looking to throw. Got him downfield. He's run out of bounds, but a big play on that one, and it'll be a first down.
Man, that quarterback knew that was a tiny window to throw into, and he just showed off his cannon of an arm.
From the 44-yard line, the offense snaps it on first down. Back to pass, it's Rising. They're working that left side. And they'll finally get him down after a terrific pickup. Now they've got to hustle to the line and get set. Going up top on first down. Moving, keeping the eyes downfield. He'll try to do it himself. Nice run there to keep things moving before they force him out of bounds.
And I think this is important for this defense. This will be a big key in the football game. Like, I got to limit the damage from that guy. Because that's a QB that's dynamic, and he can make so many big plays. I got to string him out. I got to make him get to the sideline. But I will say this. I do want to hit him at the end of the runs. I don't want to let him out of bounds and let him get free carries. I want it to be physical.
Just about had another one picked off. They've already thrown three in this game. They're lucky it wasn't four there. It's great for this quarterback to take shots down the field, but you just don't want it to feel like a give up or a chuck it up and hope kind of play.
And I think understanding the situation, now I'm on defense, right? If they're going to take shots down the field, maybe I'm a little bit more aggressive with my blitz, understanding that everything's going to take a little bit more time to develop if they're going to take those deep shots.
Caught near the sticks. It's McClain. Good job running that route to get past the sticks because he got nothing after the catch. The receivers often will run their route based on a side adjustment. Looking to go up top on first down. Quarterback moving. Trying to make magic on the scramble. And that defense doesn't allow a cutback, and they get him out of bounds after a short gain.
And that's a really good job by this defense, because remember, when the quarterback runs, now you got an extra blocker, because he's not just handing it off and standing there, and they still did a good job at the point of attack, kind of strung it along and made him run out of bounds.
Here on second and nine, sends three receivers to the right. To the air, it's Rising. Using his feet to buy time. Finally run out of bounds, but he has this offense rolling with a first down.
When you're trailing in the fourth quarter, it's so hard to get drives together because the clock starts to be your enemy. Really heads up play by the quarterback, getting the first down, get out of bounds, and stop the clock.
Got his man quickly. And he takes this one into the end zone, and all of a sudden, we've got a chance at a finish.
And listen, still a ways to go, but great job by this offense getting you back in the ballgame. Now, we got a one-possession game. We got our score. We did what we're supposed to do. Now, how do we get this stopped? Now, the defense has to come up big and get me the rock back.
On to attempt the try. And it's up and good as they draw just a touch closer. They put together a 74-yard touchdown drive. The clock is just inside, 50 seconds to play. If they don't recover the onside kick, this one is all but over. Few anxious moments there, but the hands team, true to its name, as they make the grab and get the ball. State has it back in the offense, headed to the field. Guys, you want to be productive here and not go into a shell, but you've got to take care of the ball.
Yeah, and I think you say productive, Reese. Productive at this point in the game is running the clock and getting first down. So, Jesse, I can expect this defense to be aggressive, way up near the line of scrimmage, bringing a bunch of bodies, trying to stop the run.
And that's why it puts a lot of pressure on an offense, David, because you know if you do try to throw the football, it's probably man coverage. You're probably getting blitzed. It's going to be into a small window. It is not easy to execute in this situation of the game.
DBs locked up tight on the receivers. Touch pass on the jet sweep. Runs through a tackle. And he goes out of bounds after coming up with positive yardage there. Second down coming up.
Blue 22!
They'll run play action. He's knocked down in the backfield, a swarming defense, and he'll lose 7. Quick timeout called by the defense, stopping the clock to save as much time as possible for their offense. A third and long coming up here. Looking for a man. It's McCall. And the pressure will get there. The sack. Down he goes in the waning moments. That could be a costly play. The Wolfpack will have to bring the punt team onto the field. He ought to be able to use his first punt to pin him deep. And I don't think they got it snapped before the play clock ran out. And the coach accepts it, they will take the penalty. The Wolfpack will line up to punt it away. Three and out, they got stuck in reverse. They hope the punt can bail them out. 4th down, and the punt team sends it the other way. And the coverage team able to wrestle him down. Got to get everybody lined up quickly. Time winding away, and they've got to push the ball down the field. Gives it to the back on the draw. Crosses the 30. He's got away. Nothing but green ahead. The 40. At the 20. Touchdown, Utah! And they grab the advantage, taking the lead here in the fourth.
Man, what a great job by this offense executing down the field, using all of the clock, being smart, getting the big score late, and I think that one should do it.
Man, that was exhilarating. Incredible game from start to finish, and I mean the very finish.
And you have to dial in at those moments, right? It's easier said than done. Oh, I'm going to call this. But in the clutch, when you need it the most, you've got to put possessions together. You've got to get in the end zone to come through. This offense has got to be jacked.
Looking back on it, too, was there ever any doubt that was the guy they were going to go to when the game was on the line? This dude's been making plays all season long. You've got to put the ball in the hands of your best playmakers in situations like that, and that's what they did.
That's going to do it for us from here. For Jesse Palmer, David Pollack, I'm Reese Davis, and this has been another presentation of EA Sports College Football.